Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play UFO Enemy Unknown. I'm your host, That Guy, and let's get cracking. What are we up to? Yeah, we're doing a large alien ship that we've just taken out, and I should. Oh, I don't know who was at the beginning now. So this is kind of stupid. Was it? Oh, it'll be Holly. Yeah, Holly will get point. So will Ness. I know what you're probably thinking. It's a stupid idea to, try to do this at range. But I just feel like taking some live aliens. Really, something a bit different. Starting on the left side of the map, and looks like we are gone too far away. I can't see. Middle left of the map. Okay. Haven't done one of these ships in a while, actually. So we're gonna have to just play it by ear and hope we're safe. Nor do we actually know what kind of enemies we're going to be facing. Not to mention, we wouldn't be able to see this way because the ramp's in the way. But still. Actually, I think I know what kind of ship this is. Pretty sure I do. But it doesn't mean that we can't be really bloody careful about it, because in my experience, amount of stuff that can happen in games is just really, really bloody dangerous. So we can't duck, so we can't do a firing line into the building either. That's a bit too close, to tell the truth. That's one square over and we end up hitting our nest there, so we'll just deploy everyone else in the meantime. Keep going. Oh, Wix has spotted something. Snake Man. I always wondered why the Snake Men are orange. Like, of all the colors they could choose, they chose orange for the palette. I mean, they didn't look that bad. To tell the truth, in the other UFO game that I played, the one that I'm not recommending for LPing, main reason because you need to capture leaders like crazy in it. You need to have, about at least 20 leaders to capture. And they don't appear all the time. Actually, in fact, there's actually a mod that lets them spawn more often. And they are actually more powerful, so it's a little tough, but you do need to capture as many as you can, and the leader, Snake Man, actually appears green, whereas the others appear kind of a murky brown color. I guess you could say poo colored, but actually, sorry, I just gave everyone a really bad image there. But yeah, they end up a different color, and they actually don't look that bad. The UFO one I was talking about just then was, I think it's extraterrestrials. I'm pretty sure it is. Which is also available on Steam, but as I said, it's on the new 3D style of gaming. It's not actually the same as the other styles of XCOM. So it actually is 3D, and you can look around, and it can only be played in real time, which is what I hate about the game. I can understand what they're trying to do, but they just don't do it very well. Shall we take this one out? He's probably only a soldier anyway. If he's right in front of our base like this, he's probably just a soldier. So let's just take him out directly. There we go. Good work, Ness. And everyone just fly away while Holly's stuck there on the ground. Without any flying armor. Generally, the entrance to these kind of ships is either Actually, I think there's one here. And there should be one here. I want to try to do a simultaneous entry, so that way we can flank aliens as well as we're going to clear out any aliens outside. So I just kind of want to get the field of view, just so I don't get what happened with the battleship last time, where, you know, they were obviously, I left one that was outside until, well, I didn't even know what it was doing outside the whole time. So might need to. The thing is, when you're hovering, I'm pretty sure you don't use energy. Can't remember. Let's just try it out. Come on, get rid of that time unit thing. Okay. Yeah, 56. Move here. 34. Oh, so it did. In Apocalypse, it doesn't use time units to fly, which is great. Not to mention, in Apocalypse, you can enter. The UFOs have different entryways, so you can enter from this side, or this side, or this side. Assuming that there is actually a proper entry, you can't just make an entry in it, you can't blow a hole in it, as far as I'm aware. Although, when you take down UFOs, it looks really good, because, obviously this UFO we took down ourselves, but for some reason it looks like it landed. But the UFOs in Apocalypse, when they crash land, they have huge craters behind them, and actually you can actually use the crater, and we shouldn't be able to see in there. they have huge craters behind them, and you can basically jump in the crater. If you don't have flying armor, actually you're stuck in there sometimes. Your units can jump in it, but it's a very awkward looking jump. You might as well not be jumping. But it's kind of funny to watch. Okay, let's go this way. And, okay, just remember, we're on the second floor here, not the first floor. So, the entryway isn't here. Oh, hello. I don't have any turn units. Or enough turn units to make a shot. But here's on the ground, so I can. Ooh, I'm probably not going to make it, am I? Probably not going to be a see him in time. Not really see him in time, I guess, but if we go down a floor. Oh, now we don't have enough turn units to shoot! Oh, damn it! Yeah, going down one actually does use turn units, but it does get the second level out of the way. So, that was very bad movement of me. I'm really sorry about that. I pretty much just killed a character. Oh, well, not Raptor, at least. And, well, it might not be Karla, even. And probably not Trevor! Unless they're smart enough to walk forward, obviously, but, let's just see what happens first. Wix, at least, will have a chance to do returning fire. So that's good. We'll save here. Yeah, it's funny, I always keep doing these saves, but I never actually load them. So, yeah, that. Oh, damn it. I really did not want to see smoke. So the Illyrium inside it's been destroyed. Damn it. These things here are classified as alien food, which don't mean much at all in the game. I'm not kidding either. They just don't mean jack crap in the game. Might as well not put them in the game, because you can't do anything with it. Like, you gotta do stuff to research, but in the end, there's no point in researching it, because it doesn't tell you anything. Yeah, so the entryway into the ship is that panel, and I think one of these panels, I can't see because of smoke, so. Oh, let's get over there, I guess. Damn it. I mean, what you could do is reload and do it again, but I'm not going to be that cheap. This is a bit too much cheating. Like, there's no real way to see that enemy, but for some reason we can. Hey, shoot him! Go, Wix! Yeah! I really should have turned that person around as well, because front armor is the best in the game. Under armor is the worst, which is why flying up is not such a good idea all the time, but at the same time, you're if you scatter all your units, then you got a better chance in general. Yeah, this is the top floor, actually. Sometimes you can even bust a hole in here, and that's actually not a bad thing to do in the game. You heard Karla? No. See? How good is armor in this game? Now, granted, it doesn't always work, but just by being able to survive one heavy plasma shot, that's already good enough, because, you know, before we had, what, clothing armor, 2 or something like that, I think getting hit by that rocket took away 5 armor from under armor, and it reduced Raptor into... You're on fire, buddy! Do you not understand the problem that you're having right now? You're on fire. And they're facing towards us as well, which is also kind of a problem. So, if we miss with the stun bomb, we'll end up getting ourselves killed. That's what we get. Retaliate, probably, but that's why I'm choosing to kill rather than to do anything else. You'll have to wait outside, Holly, though. Okay. Can you get Mark 6? Yeah, see, I really don't understand how we can actually see there. Unless this roofing has been destroyed, but obviously it's not, and I don't understand what's going on. Now, the way up is actually through there, or you can take the one here. One of them goes straight to the top floor, and the other one goes just to the second floor, which I think... this nearby one only goes to the second floor anyway, so... Oh, damn it, misclicking. This is what happens when you misclick. You end up on the wrong floor. You end up back where you started. Battle Bunny. I don't know how many times I killed Battle Bunny so far by accidental misclicking. Or by really bad tactics. Which is also just as bad. Because tactics, it's not really a hard thing to develop tactics. I'm sure that if some of you play this game, you'll even know some tactics. It doesn't even take many tactics to play this game. Like, you can just think of them off the fly. Like, you know how to flank, right? One person goes from the front, another one goes from the side, that kind of thing. Like, it's not hard per se. It's just whether the computer's going to cheat and anticipate your move, because, sometimes the computer just magically appears and just, smashes everyone. Or, as what's happened so far many times is, I've entered a room and, I'll say stand here, click here, and then the door opens and I can't move because, the computer's right in my face already. And, they were probably hoping reaction fire would do it for them, but obviously not. So... Trevor's nearly out of energy as well. Don't really want to take him for a breather, but... let's just see how we go here. Should be okay. The reason being, because there's no real doors on the bottom floor. Except for the one directly nearby where we enter, actually. So, what I mean by that is... Obviously, there's meant to be walls here, which have been destroyed, but I don't think the computer's actually going to use that door, and the computer can walk through that door, but I don't see much point in it. So, let's just walk around the corner and see if we have anyone. Yes, we do. Sorry, buddy. And that'll do Karla. Now. Trevor can stand there. Wix can also cover. Kitty Cat! You're not in front of the door. Holly, you're in front of the door. Now, the funny thing is, there you go. I didn't think so. One of the Illyriums is still intact. So, it's very good. Teleporting pad, be careful around them as usual. At this point, we will renegotiate our forces by spreading them up a bit. Reconsolidate our forces, I should say. This is really dangerous, actually, because I just realized that we don't have any turn units. They're all just stopping in front of the pad, and we don't have any turn units in case anything comes down. So we're pretty much walking into a death trap, so I've done another bad tactics. Getting a little tired of doing this. This is why I like blast bombs. Just make a hole in the wall of it yourself, and then you can just firing squad in or stun bomb in, and there's your tactical entry. But no, I'm not. Haven't got them yet, so I can't do it as yet. Enemies wandering around somewhere that I don't know. Only gonna get one Illyrium. Okay. Trevor. Clear? Clear. Okay. Ness, you've got the stun weapon, so if you don't mind, I'd like you to go first. And Kitty Cat, could you provide backup? Thank you. In the meantime, Karla's going here. And Wix is going here. Holly, enough wasting time. Oh, jeez. Okay. The big problem here is I don't know what kind of enemy this is. This is why I kind of like having stun rods, but at the same time, it weighs down your characters too much if they're, like, not experienced enough. So, I could stun this one, but chances are it's just going to be another soldier. So... it is possible to actually see what weapon the enemy has. Sometimes, like, you actually just... if you can figure out the way that they hold the guns, but I'm not experienced enough at this game to do that, unfortunately. Uh-huh. It's fine. To be honest, this is obviously the way the game's meant to be played as well. Not so much saving and... stuff. Ooh, hello. It's one kill for that guy. Oh, take the hit. Take two hits. Very slow shot. See, this is where the other team will go up, but they'll actually go up to the next floor as well. So, yeah. This floor is a bit of a waste, but, it's basically their little holding area. So, you can get Nickers up here as well. So if they come in, Nickers can have a chance to react. Or at least just absorb one shot and take them out as well. In fact, we'll have Nickers take one step forward. By the end of the game, if you do actually have the same guys all the way through the game, they are so professional, like they are so well balanced out that they pretty much do all the fighting themselves. Like, reaction fight will take more than do more kills than actual fighting. And we've already moved, so we probably shouldn't move them in. We'll have to wait till next turn for these guys. But it is funny, because I have seen it done before, where people have just done it naturally, and just gone out and done the whole stage, and basically, their units, they haven't actually clicked on enemies to shoot them, like, the interruptions is what's killing all the enemies. And that's something you really don't want to see in games, because basically it means that you've cheated. Another example of that is... Conflict Desert Storm? I think it is. Is that the one where you have like three people and you have a team basically? But the thing in that is you tell the team what to do, and you tell them whether to go live, fire, or silent, or whatever it is. I can't remember exactly, but during the stage, I think you play as like an officer, so you don't actually do much yourself. You tell everyone what to do. So you're not actually doing all the shooting yourself, you're telling them to shoot, but at the same time, half the time when the enemy shows up, they're already shooting at them before you even spotted them. And then by the time you see them, they're already falling over, and your team's saying, "Tango down." Which, I gotta say, I always found it amusing in the game anyway, but, you know, that's not how a game's supposed to be. Like, it's not a movie type thing where, you know, the only thing you actually get to see is tango down and then a person falling away because they just got shot. I can't see what weapon you've got, buddy. Please don't mind being stunned. Man. It's probably gonna cross me. Trev, can you cover? What we could do is a stun chain, and we use Trevor to stun Ness, and then Trevor can move out of the way, and... Ugh. That's really messy, though. I really don't want to do that. Let's just go. Forget it. Get killed, you get killed. Probably not, though, to be honest. Because it... As you can see, like, it's rare to have, like, multiple enemies show up in the same screen, even. So, you don't really need to worry too much about it. You too, huh? Alright, we'll stun ourselves. Oops! Oh, that's okay. You can have another! It's on me! On the house! That was still stun. There you go. How stupid's that? Okay, what happened there, in case you guys are wondering? We already had stun up to, I think, about here with Ness, and then when we stunned again, it probably jumped to, like, you know, somewhere around here, because we're right next to him. What happened from that point was we got damaged, and our overall health became lower than our grey health. So, what happened is basically, yeah, because our grey health outnumbered our actual health, we get stunned. Yeah, it's not exactly the easiest thing to explain, but you won't be in many instances like that. The computer only uses stun weaponry when they're using medics against you, which obviously is not common. I can't tell what weapon that is. But if I had to guess, I'd say that's a launcher. Unfortunately, none of these guys are carrying, don't appear to be carrying, small launchers, stun weapons. Sorry, when I say launcher, I mean a blaster launcher, so the most powerful launcher weapon. No, he's carrying a rifle. And he just killed me with a rifle. Something I definitely don't like about this. Okay, try again. You shot my friend. Now we shoot you. One thing that is also a problem now. Ness may be wounded, which means that she's draining health per turn, and we need to finish... Oh, you did have a launcher. We need to finish this battle sooner rather than later. And I mean, like, very soon. As in, like... You know, within the next two turns soon, which isn't exactly an easy thing to do, but, as I said, sooner rather than later. Let's see. Okay. We'll have to wait a turn, unfortunately. So I bet you another one's going to show up right where the last one was, and we're going to open that door, and there's going to be another one there. Let's just watch it right happen now. Oh. Okay. Enemies were Snake Man Leader, which we don't need. Snake Man Soldier, which we don't need either. Great. Come on, keep turning. There we go. Now, the control room in this area is that room there. And we've seen another enemy. Oh, everyone can get stunned today, I think. I find it more amusing that everyone is actually getting stunned. Because usually when I use stun weapons, it doesn't work for crap. Let's just do a two-person breach, actually, now I think about it. It's just probably easier. I've had enough of, you know, getting everyone around. If we're trying to finish it quicker, then we need to lose a bit of tactics and do a bit more rushing. Although, of course, try not to rush and get ourselves killed, though. That's a bad place to end a turn. Okay. Out of, small launcher shots. What do we get? Another leader. I believe that this ship is actually called the supply one, if you remember me talking about that earlier. Oh, that is a very bad end of turn. That's really not what I wanted to do. Can't click here for some reason. Is it because there's an enemy there? No. Okay. Ugh. Alright, let's just walk up to the door anyway. Try not to, end your turn in the open like I'm doing. Nice shooting, you're hitting the corner. Oh, you hit me once. How many shots are you going to take? Please be over. Oh, that is two auto-fire rounds, basically. That's probably another leader as well. But we're injured, so we can't hit him. As well, I should probably stand right next to him. Nope. Actually, it looked like they had a small launcher there for a second. Might be a medic. I doubt it, but it might. Okay, we really want to walk around this corner and not see an enemy. Yes. One room left. No more aliens left anyway. Okay. So we lost one operative, which was... When was it? I don't know. I can't remember anymore. But we got a lot of stuff for it, which is very good. As I said, food, alloys, illyrium. Got a bit of everything, basically, which is always good to see. Let's see if we can quickly figure out who we lost. Wasn't Kitty Cat, Raptor. It was Knickers. Damn it. I believe Knickers up to Mark 3 now, actually. Which isn't that bad, actually. Yep. So you done? You only get a power set for now, if that's alright, buddy. We're missing a Zack. As well, just realized. If I'm correct, we should be up to Mark 3 as well. Should be. I'm not saying that we are, but I'm pretty sure it's Mark 3. Not that it really matters anyway. No, wait, it's 4. It's 4. Okay. Back to base. Yep, everyone can return home. It's fine. We know you can return home. What I forgot to do is equip Zack with some form of armor at least. Even though we don't need that many, it's good to see. Heavy lasers. Get them out there. Get the production line going. Oh, quite a few days going past. No worries. And... what's it going to do? Oh, that's right. Put you guys on a ship. Oh god. 10 people to do a base. And there'll be 4 rookies. Do we really think this is possible? With blaster bombs it is, yes. We'll do it that way. As soon as we get blaster bombs, we're going for the enemy base. Screw it. What kind of ship is this? Oh, it's just a simple scout. That's alright. No, we should move in, actually. Okay. Large scout. Taken down. How are we on research? Blast launcher. Poor! Oh, it is pretty high tech though. that's like final level technology. So it, yeah, it takes a while for it to get through. Yeah, let's just do that little stage. That's all right. Actually, we will save that for our next video. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you don't mind me ending so abruptly, but I really am out of time. And I hope that you enjoyed watching. So, as per usual, take care of yourselves out there, yeah?